described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
TMW Media Group presents Radio Astronomy, the Alma Telescope. A spiral of various colors curls in space.
Radio astronomy is the study of the invisible universe.
The spiral's image is isolated and expanded.
We see the world around us because our eyes detect visible light, a type of electromagnetic radiation. Objects on Earth and in space also emit other types of electromagnetic radiation that cannot be seen by the human eye, such as radio waves
and X-rays.
The full range of radiation emitted by an object is called its electromagnetic spectrum. Radio astronomy allows us to study celestial objects that emit radio waves. Since radio waves penetrate dust, scientists use radio astronomy techniques to study regions that cannot be seen in visible light, such as the dust-shrouded environments where stars and planets are born.
A supermassive black hole is identified.
And the center of our galaxy, the Milky Way.
An image of an orange streak has the titles Gamma Ray Sky and Fermi Satellite.
Radio waves also allow astronomers to trace the location, density, and motion of the hydrogen that constitutes 3/4 of the ordinary matter in the universe. Radio frequency waves that penetrate Earth's atmosphere range from wavelengths of a few millimeters to nearly 100 meters. They induce a very weak electric current in a conductor, such as an antenna.
Like one on a portable radio.
Most radio telescope antennas are parabolic or dish-shaped reflectors. They gather the radiation and reflect it to a central focus where the radiation is concentrated. The weak current at the focus can then be amplified by a radio receiver, so it is strong enough to measure and record. The strength of radio frequency energy reaching Earth is small compared to the radiation received in the visible range. Therefore, a radio telescope must have a large collecting area, or antenna. Using two or more radio telescopes together, called an array, and combining the signals they simultaneously receive allows astronomers to see more detail.
A celestial region becomes clearer.
This ability depends on a technique called radio interferometry. When signals from two or more telescopes are properly combined, the telescopes can effectively act as small pieces of a single huge telescope. The National Radio Astronomy Observatory chose the Atacama Desert of northern Chile for their newest venture, the Alma Telescope.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.